Guys, it's Fonzie from the Mustek Project in Motus Richards Bay. Probably the biggest buzzword, entrepreneurship. Speak to me, especially you youngsters from the University of Zululand. I want to encourage you to get involved in an entrepreneurial way. Let me help you guys. Come and speak to me, 067-107-8012. Mustek Project, Motus Richards Bay. Thank you.
Let's chill, live a podcast. 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 Hope you all are focused. Let's share what inside. Who knows, might get something inside. Let's chill, live a podcast. 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 Hope you all are focused. Let's share what inside. Who knows, might get something inside. Let's chill, live a podcast. 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 Yeah, lot of things be happening around the campus. And as fast as like a head strike upon us, who gon' help us? I guess it's obvious. With the voice, with the eyes, we gon' do that. Talk about things that really matter. From registration to allocation, take it straight up to academics. Never leave out all the finance issues. All the finance issues. Never leave out all the finance issues. All the finance issues. Never leave out all the finance issues.
Welcome back with Campus Connect Podcast. Dumelani molweni sanibonani. Usahle nayo kwabajosi maqabula sondela into ezimnandi. Into ezohlala ikhithi kuthathi kubeke ikhiphi kufaka. Khlele kumnandi, khlele kumoja, khlele kushap. Namhlanje angihambi ngedwa, ngiphethe indoda enobuchopho, ngiphethe indoda ecabanga kakhulu. Ngiphethe umphathi wabantu abaningi abamazi, nizomazi kodwa namhlanje ukuthi ngivakashela ubaba. Babu Sehlogo, ngikubingelele usazobingelela ababukeli be Campus Connect.
Ngithi ngibingelele kubo bonke abaphethe lohlelo le Campus Connect, and I'm here to engage.
Siyabonga. Babukeli be Campus Connect, ngingakokwandi ngisazokwanda kakhulu. Namhlanje sivakashelwe ubaba Sehlogo, the director of EPSD khona lapha University of Zululand. Ozosibikela kabanzi mayelana nomsebenzi we-PSD usuka nokuhlala kwawo since sama student. Maningi kakhulu ama student angazi mayelana nomsebenzi we-PSD. Namhlanje ubaba Sehlogo uzosithulela kabanzi ngomsebenzi wama PSD ukusuka nokuhlala ukuprotecta ama student. Babu Sehlogo, mhlawumbe siqala nje, mhlawumbe ungasibeka ngama roles and responsibilities of the protective service department in the University of Zululand.
Okay. I protective services department,
yes,
it has a role of being a parent.
Okay.
And one would ask ukuthi, what do I mean by that? Perhaps I should actually start by saying what we do, our primary role is to ensure ukuthi institution with the primary client, which is our student, are secured. Uh-huh. The assets of the university and the staff, including visitors, are also secured. So that is the primary role. But there are many other things that come with that role. We are here 24/7.
Okay.
Because we are here 24/7, the students that live here need services. And some of the services have got nothing to do with security. Mm. For instance, students will come and say, I'm a plug assembling here to our sabians. Mm. And they would report Gupi a PSD. And then a PSD will have to find electrician to come and assist.
Okay.
If gonna issue a plumbing, a PSD will have to find a plumber to come and assist, or a carpenter to come and assist.
Okay.
That is just one aspect. Another aspect, students are by nature very consumed by a whole lot of things. Mm. They are consumed by their books, they are consumed by their life as young people and all that. And some of them are so excited to be here, such that they become a little bit vulnerable and careless.
Yes.
Such that they will leave their stuff here, ahambe umuntu aye toilet, akazi muntu la phakathi kwethu sonke. Kodwa uzawushiya izinto zakhe ahamba e-toilet, makabuya lezinto zihambile.
Asekho.
Asekho. So yithe kufanele ukuthi sicinge lezinto siyithole. How do we do that? It's things that we will explain at a later stage. But also we make sure ukuthi si create ama access points.
Uh-huh.
Taking into consideration ukuthi sikwi university which does not have a perimeter fence.
Yes.
So we make sure ukuthi kuma various entry points wama buildings. For instance, you go to the library, you go to a admin building, you go to even here kuma NEs. There's always security which is overseeing things. And this security, it's warm bodies.
Okay.
And these warm bodies also need to be assisted with a technology, which then talks to issue your installation of our cameras and all these things.
Okay.
And these cameras are the ones now that are becoming critical in some of the things that we do. For instance, if you've left your stuff and went to the toilet, you come back, that stuff is gone. Fanukutisfunewuti, who might have removed that stuff? So those are some amongst many other things that we do.
Okay.
We used to do AMA student cards. We've moved that task to e office lager registry.
Okay.
Because one of the reasons that task should have been moved or that task should be moved from us. The question yoguti, we are unable, due to a separation of duties, unable to do ama verification yoguti undosi is actually registered. Can we verify that? No, we can't. We need office lager registrar to do that verification. So then it became easier. We would know, let's take even the task of my student cards, EAGOP, go register, so that they can do a verification. And after doing a verification, they can be in the position to print a student card for you, which has got all the details that are necessary, even our number at the back of that student card. So those are some amongst the duties that we do.
Okay.
Yes.
Babsitlogo, siyajabula, siyathokoza ngamazwi othe wasithulela wena. Mhlawumbe babusetlogo, usachaza ngomsebenzi we-PSD usanaba ngawo. Mhlawumbe njengoba sinama student ahlala off campus amaningi, isebenza kanjani i-PSD? Iyakwazi yini ungenelela off campus okanye igcina la ngaphakathi on campus?
Okay. I-PSD as an entity, I role yayo, it's within the campus borders or the campus precinct.
Yes.
But what the university management decided to do,
yes,
is to assist by bringing what is called the MGUT app.
Okay.
This app, it's an app that all students need to acquaint themselves with.
Okay.
Students must download this app, babe na ema phone in abo, so that magunama issues, there's a panic that they can press in the app. The app would simply tell a control room ye emka to guti undosi unenkinga, and immediately it geolocate, it creates
location.
A location,
yes,
where ndosi is.
Okay.
And then we can dispense a team, your security, to go and assist. Under normal circumstances, any space outside the perimeter or the location of the university.
Okay.
E security akona e task ye South African police.
Okay.
But we know ukuthi e South African police is overwhelmed with a whole lot of issues. Issues is a manpower, issues is a Zama resources and all that. So we've then brought in this armed response team. I'm sure you know Uguti, e police university is to have a campus which is gun free.
Okay.
But we have security officers that you will see carrying guns. They are part and parcel of the armed response team. You must understand, Uguti, where we are in Gadlangezwa and Vulindlela, the village itself forms part of the microcosm of society. So is our campus. Our campus is part of this microcosm, and there will be a whole lot of criminality that happens in society in general. And I do not want to go into the reasons why those things are there, but one amongst it's the issue of unemployment. There's a whole lot of young people who are not employed, and they have to survive. And if they have to survive, there's a whole lot of targets that are brought. Considering as a university, we've got how many students? Plus minus 18,000? In that 18,000, about 2.5 maybe by Sir Richards Bay. And then Lagwadlangezwa, we've got close to about maybe 15,500 students, of which 3,500 are on campus.
On campus?
Yes. And then about 11 to 12,000 students by Lagwe community. So those are targets for any criminal activity that, or criminals that might actually see a potential to make a living out of them. Hence, we've got this issue. Yeah, lama criminal, lama student, abiza kuthi amadabuka.
Amadabuka.
Yeah. And maybe story samadabuka, it's another story which needs to be corrected. Amadabuka, what does dabuka mean to you? What does it mean to you?
Eh, babu sitloko uma ukhuluma ngamadabuka kushoqisa igazi, because siyibona le nto eyenzakalayo inhlekelele eyisimanga kakhulu. Ubuka ama student ezela ezofunda kodwa afike izinto zimikame ngenxa yamadabuka. I safety and security, since ukhona nawe la sifisa ukhulume kabanzi ngayo. Ezinye zezinto mhlawumbe ezidale ukuthi sikubize babu sitloko, amadabuka ezinye zeizathu ezibanga ukuthi sikubize uzocacisa mayelana namadabuka, ngoba isihlava esesine kakhulu lapha edlangezwa and umphakathi awukhulumi ngaso.
Okay, you have not given me an answer yokuthi yini amadabuka.
Okay, amadabuka,
yeah,
I think amadabuka babusetloho igebengu.
Okay, let me give you the knowledge that I have about amadabuka.
Okay.
Amadabuka, basically it's a term which was used to coin abafundi ebe babuya out of this area.
Okay.
Badabuka
la
kwezinye indawo.
Oh.
Badabuka kubo Goli, badabuka kubo Free State and so on, bazofunda la.
Bazofunda la.
So when I was growing up, for instance, I had a cousin who studied here.
Okay.
Ngama late 70s and 80s.
Okay.
So I'm not giving away my age, but I used to bengipheleze lo cousin wami ayogibela ibhasi. Lelo bhasi lelo lalisuka kubo Soweto lize kubo Binoni, you know, the whole of West Rand and East Rand. Lihamba likolekta ama students bewasuka ngale eza Ongoye.
Okay.
So mabafika la, they were referred to as amadabuka. Kuthi ayidabuka lo umuntu okuhamba.
Umuntu okuhamba.
Uyangithola.
Oh, sengiyakuthola.
That's where this term comes from.
Okay.
But you know, you had young people ababuya kubo Soweto who looked at the people here. This was a typical rural environment.
Okay.
So they thought they are smart, benza ubugebengu and all that. Then it moved from being a term coined for abantu bokuhamba to criminals. Kuthi abantu abenza ubugebengu la yila madabuka la. Uyangithola. Understand. So now, who do we have as a madabuka? You know, you look at e period between e recess, yaga December and January.
In January, okay.
There is no crime in Dlangezwa.
Yeah, unga should pin.
There is no crime. Nothing. Quiet.
Indaba yonakala nje kufika ama student.
Once I'm a student, I figure. Once I'm a student, I figure namadabuka yavuka. So what does that tell you? you need to start thinking ukuthi most of amadabuka, when they commit these criminalities,
yes,
they cover their faces.
Okay.
Why should they cover their faces? I mean, you have people abahambayo bayoyenza ama cash in transit heist.
Yes.
They don't even cover their faces.
Yes.
They just go and commit the crime and that's it. But laba, because abantu enhlala nabe ezindlini,
esibazi,
abantu enibaziyo, they cover their faces to commit this criminality. So amadabuka, you know, it might be a controversial thing, but majority amadabuka, you know, we had a sad situation that maybe should not be repeated. A young man was murdered through Imob Justice about 2 years ago. And this young man was identified by a number of young female students who said, "Nangu lobe kahamba na matabuga izolepsuku." And he was then attacked and he was murdered. What does that tell you? Nga matabuga. There is a link. If you look at the fact, Yoguti, when the students are not here, there is absolutely no crime. Once the students come, the levels of the crime is yakupu. You can go to Mtunzin and go and look at OB, yeah, boy, occurrence book, yeah.
Okay.
It tells you that when there are no students, they can stay for days without recording any criminal case. But once students come, there's many things that can be attributed to that. It could be that some students are criminals themselves.
Okay.
It could be the fact that students are generally targets because they have got all the things that criminal wants. Criminal wants things that are easy to sell. So students have got phones, students have got ama weaves, students have got
laptops,
they've got techies, they've got money, and so on and so on.
So many things, okay.
So all those things actually makes them vulnerable to the criminals that we today know or call amadabuka. So now, this is where your first question, which, or the earlier question, which talks about the issue here, what is actually PSD doing? But what is the university doing? The university has brought in this MCAT app. And I think that's one thing that we need to emphasize on. Because it's not going to work if our students
and I seven's.
You know, you had those students who had an unfortunate situation, bangenelwa ama criminals, la guamataba or guamatabel. And we end up gutubulega u
Okay, take.
When I checked with EMGA to Guti, these guys beba mover from room to room. Is there any student, well, while that was happening, because they did not rob all the students, they robbed a certain number of students.
Okay.
But while that activity was happening, students were screaming and all that. Did anyone, just one person, send a panic, Uguti, hey, we are in trouble here? Nothing. And that weekend, three residences were robbed. Any resident, somewhere in Apenzansi, Gamkwanazi, was also robbed. A similar thing happened. The modus, it's the same. They come, bakhokhisa bamu, bangene room to room, batatama laptops, batate ini and all that. Why can't one person osese na iphone yakhe
press the button?
I button, so that kube ne reaction from me control. What is happening? Asho atisenda wenenje. This is what is happening, and then kube ne reaction. So that's one thing. The other thing is, gune CPF around here, and ECPF, it's a community policing forum.
Okay.
Community Policing Forum is actually formed by the landlords, it's formed by members of the community, together, working together with the South African police.
Okay.
So this is after realizing, and ECPF, it's actually a community project which is all over South Africa.
Okay.
Realizing Uguti, we've got a problem, yama resources with the police. The police are not always available.
Okay.
And I think it's because of also how we have been structured as a security cluster. And I'm counting us also as a PSD. PSD, how many security do we have? In total, we've got about 48 members as a PSD. And then we brought in our service providers like MCAT and Excellent.
Okay.
To add the numbers. So on a daily basis, in total, we've got about 130 people that are protecting a campus. Different areas, you know, faculties, our residences, at the gate, patrolling all over and all that. And nowadays, what we have done, we've also included those that are not in uniform, that are working with you, because of the fact that e-campus, it's open to everyone.
Yeah.
So because it's open to everyone, criminals that we see coming, they come dressed like you as students, bakerabo paga, bafagama earphones. Normal student.
Hey.
You think this is a student only to find this is actually a criminal. And what do they do? Bangena la kuma faculties, bawoka ma offices all over here. Bangene ba check iminyango. Ukuthi iminyango ivaliwe and staff members and students bane tendency ukuthi mhlambe benihleli nifunda la.
Yes.
Then niya decide le bafetha sambe sofuna ukudla. Niyaphuma nonke akekho no one ocabanga ukuthi asilokheni la. So aniloki nishiya this pod room unlocked and your laptops and stuff are here. A guy comes, we are collector, and some of these guys are guys who are students here, but they live here in the community. Some of them, you'll see them magunama protest. They are part of the protest
only,
but they are not students. But the fact is that you guys nipila nabo, I uskaizolo outiam spila na ye, and we think he's a student, and yet he's not a student. And that is why we moved the issue your keeper ama student card from PSD, because we can't verify mawuza uti nizo yenze student card. Sifaka kuphi ku office
la register.
Because the registrar will simply look at the verification that okay, he is registered, then agnigas a student card. We couldn't do that. So that created another element of vulnerability. Yoguti, these guys ebahleli la bangahambi babuyele emakhaya because they could not finish
qualifications.
Yes. Abo. They become part of our protest. They become part of the criminality that we see in this university. And it's because singavale gating. But ngaphe mall kuvulekile. Ngale emhlangeni
kuvulekile.
Baphuza nani futhi khona lapha emhlangeni. They know when you've received your stipend. And when you've received your stipend, niphathi imali la. Nigcwala lapha kuma ATMs niyo withdraw imali. So i-life yama student ihamba ngepattern, you can actually see. So if you look at the crime, when you guys don't have money, crime is less. But once niba nemali, iyakhuphuka. Because ninale nto efunwa ile gang le eyama criminals. So all those things are actually saying to you, what is happening in society in general would also happen here.
In the school.
At the university. So now, the point that I was trying to raise earlier on the question ukuthi, as a community, the Gadlangezwa Vulindlela community, together with the university, we are actually sitting tomorrow.
Okay.
It's a Wednesday, né? The
24th. Yes, yeah, it's the 24th.
We are sitting tomorrow, and we are going to come up with ways and means. So, ukuthi si try to resolve some of these issues. There's one thing that I fear about the whole thing, because some of the people that are going to be part and parcel of this.
Yeah, yeah.
Amapogopogo. The guys Ebagu Taxi Association. The guys who are not very shy in actually taking out a gun and shoot.
Yes.
So if kwenzakala I criminality anywhere, I'm sure you remember about a year or two ago when our students were robbed in Letwala.
Dwalabahle, yes.
And then amabhokobhoko ran to the scene
and shot.
And they shot.
Yes.
We could have had a situation yokuthi a student has been shot. Whether that student was Patiama Dabuga or it was just a student ebesiphuma sibaleka, we don't know. So those are some of the challenges that I have in my mind. I am for issue yokuthi magube ne CPF which is alive and aware of what is happening. So that is why we are going to sit so that we discuss these things. We discuss even ama patrol patterns sesizo wabega on the ground so that we should be visible. We are inviting companies as Jengabotronox to come and assist, maybe donate certain instruments like amapaki and all that. The traditional authority is also going to be part and parcel of this, so that our aim is to make sure Uguti, the student village, is safe. Because it's not only ingane eziphuma la endaweni, but you've got the original Matabuga, ababuya kubo Goli, ababuya kubo Western Cape, ababuya eMpumalanga, abazela abazofunda. So ama parents abo must actually get comfort with ingane zethu zisese.
So Bob Sehlogo, ngokubuka kwakho amadabuka akubona abantu bala noma abantu bala?
Well, khona manje sekuhlangene.
Sekuhlangene.
Yeah. Sekuqhovene manje, as you say. Because remember the social factors that I did not want to go into. I'm not a specialist of those things.
Yes.
But issue ye unemployment.
Yes.
Issue yeah, these guys abangahambi after they've qualified or failed to qualify. Bahleli nani la emqashweni. Remember, parents do not know 99% of the time ukuthi what are you doing wena?
Ngiyafunda noma
ngihlezi. Ngiyafunda. Khona ama students who've been here for more than 10 years.
Mm.
And ama parents abo abazi ukuthi une degree or akana i degree. They've never been here to come and see ukuthi has he graduated or not. You know?
Okay.
So all those issues are issues that compound into the problem that we have of a criminality kulenda wesikuyo. So amadabuka sewaqovene abantu bokuhamba nabantu bala. But remember what I said earlier on, ukuthi when you guys are not here, there is no crime.
There is no crime.
So you make your own deduction.
Yeah.
You make your own deduction.
And ngiyacaca ukuthi abanye bethu bama student by part and parcel of this crime.
Yeah.
So
and some of them, if we happen to catch a person or involved with crime, the first thing that they bring to our attention, ukuthi nami ngizama impilo, I'm not funded, and when we check, indeed the guy is not funded.
Kodwa manje bayabulala ma student.
Unfortunately. In fact, we are lucky in the number of years that I've been here, only two students have actually, met their demise through issue of criminality.
Because ngibuka lento ukuthi mangayona imali amadabuka zokhanda strike.
Yeah. True.
So, as EPSD, since nithinteka makhulunywa ngamadabuka, ngifisa ukwazi plan enisahleli phezu kwayo enisayi-implementa noma esikhona vele ekuthenini prevente into ey'fana nalezi ezenzakalayo njengamanje.
Let me ask you a question.
Okay.
In the crime that happens emlazi, can the police prevent it? Because a crime is something that you plan sitting somewhere after consuming couple of beers or consuming drugs and all that, then you plan the crime, you know.
Mm.
So But I've indicated to you ukuthi university, particularly security and management, the university have actually opted to bring in the MCAT app, which you guys need to help by using it. If you use this app, then sizoba in the position ukuthi si review after a certain period of time ukuthi is this thing actually working for us, you know. But if it's not used, we can't know ukuthi it's working or not working. Let me give you an example.
Okay.
When we started this app, you would remember ukuthi besinama officers bewahamba ngama quad bikes here.
I remember.
They responded to e-app ngapha emhlangeni.
Yes.
Bathe mabavela lapha emhlangeni bazithela phakathi kwegebengu that shot them. One of those officers who was shot uhamba nge-wheelchair today. Do you understand? It's an indication of the amount of crime which is prevalent in this area. You do not have a criminal who just rob undosi nge okapi, but you have criminals that are carrying guns. So e-security ye university, it's limited what we can do about. But we are not saying because our efforts are limited, we are just going to sit back and do nothing. That is why ngiteguwe tomorrow we are sitting with umphakathi, with the landlords. Okay. You know, there's a whole lot of things that can be done if we hold hands together as a community. For instance, last year we were planning to have, or it's the year before, 2022, we're planning to have what is called a campus safety Indaba.
Okay.
So the Indaba could not take place because of issue ukuthi the number of people that we had hoped to bring in was going to create a health crisis because of issue yamanzi. Siya sibe ne problem la kungabi namanzi.
Eh, isonto lonke.
Well, you know, sometimes more. And when you don't have water, what happens in the bathrooms?
Hey.
What happens, ama lecture halls and all that. And you would know ukuthi management, in fact, at one stage took a decision to suspend the academic activity.
Yes,
that helps, but it also does not necessarily resolve the problem, Yamans.
Okay.
So there's a whole lot of things that university needs to do, and of which it's not my forte, but it's space sabo infrastructure planning and all that, that needs to look at all those things. So there's a whole lot of things. If it's not issue ya manzi, issue ya electricity, luckily
Sanguinyana. Okay.
I don't know how many days, 24, 25 days, we've got electricity.
Yeah.
But the reality is, the question of safety also depends on you.
Okay.
You know what we do? We do what is called hard targeting and soft targeting. The hard targeting, it's when we bring in technology, we bring in the warm bodies.
Okay.
That are all over the place, protecting you and so on, and my residents and so on. But is soft targeting, it's what me and you are doing right now. Because we are saying the first person to protect you is yourself. If you do not think about those stuff that you've left there, if you do not think, you know, sometimes when I do my patrols, MRS, I just go and open the door, and the door opens, and there's someone sleeping there. And I go in and I stand next to them. They don't even realize that I'm in there. So you can imagine if I was a criminal.
Hey.
And this goes across the board. Males and females, they do the same. They don't lock their doors. You know, I've never seen anything like this where people think it's okay. We are putuma uyobhala exam, for instance. You were told in advance, ukuthi, phones are not allowed in the exam room. And then, uhlangana nondosi lapha. You don't know undosi. usuqelundo ukuthi akubambele ifoni yakho ungene uyobhala iexam mawuphuma
Ndosi
is not there. You don't even know his name.
Hey.
And then uyapi? Uye PSD uzo reporter kuthi ngilahlekelwe iphone nginikeza usibanibani and so on and so on. And we've got so many such cases. Abanye umuntu athatha ibag yakhe nama IDs enama card nani nani ayinikeza umuntu ongamazi. Angazi ukuthi ukuthembana osokudlulele oyini. I don't know.
Lack of reasoning.
Well, I wouldn't call it lack of reasoning. Yile nto ngithi we need to do a whole lot of soft targeting, ama awarenesses. And this is the beginning of these awarenesses. Ukuthi guys, the only person who will protect you better than anyone else, it's yourself. And how do you do that? You do that by actually thinking before uhambe uyodakwa le emhlangeni. Not knowing ukuthi mawuphuma lapha so ubudlile so grand uba nokubhekile because this is where these guys sit and watch you when you go out uto lo mjita beka phethe icard or beka phethe imali athenga lapha and all that I manje nangiseke yahamba and ngathi sekhona le mali so now bafunani bafuna le mali bafuna I cellphone lo iphete and any other thing mhlawumbe ugcoke neteki elihle yabona ngazi these days nikoka amatekwane thina sasigcoka bo Puma and all
yeah yeah sesadla wona ama Soviets lelo
yeah yabona zonke lezo zinto so we need to do more also onto soft targeting so that you guys with this project any starter
yeah podcast yes
need to push it to students you know I would also promote the question yokuthi kube na some kind of a radio station.
Radio stations, yes.
Where you guys can talk about this thing. Because it question your orientation that we do at the beginning of the year. It's a once off.
Yes.
And then it comes back next year.
Hey.
People are creatures that need to be continuously reminded of certain things.
Yeah.
But hey, guys.
Yeah.
Hey, guys. Yeah. And I mean, You'll get a report. I'll get a phone call 2 o'clock at night. Hey, sicela ukuthi sihambise nangu mfundi so sekalimele. Ulimele. What happened? Hayi ubanjwa amadabuka la ngapha 2 o'clock. It's a female or a male for that matter. Ubanjwa amadabuka because bekabuya kuphi la bekadla khona whatever le bekayidla now bekakrossa athu endlini yolala you know I mean the students ebafika lapha abashawe ngocelemba and all those things it's a clear indication ukuthi this person forgot ukuthi akekho immortal
okay
did you understand you'll die. You know, you meet these guys at night. Some of them, they realize good, they know you. Then they deal with you decisively. So you must be continuously reminded. Ukuthi, hey, yazini, kunezinto engafana. Sometimes nihamba as a group, kuze igenge ehamba ngepolo, bafike bame bakhiphe izibhamu, banthuke bathi yonke into phansi, bathathe konke and all that. So we are still lucky some of the serious crimes that we see in other places have not yet taken place here where people are actually being kidnapped and then kutholakala imizimba ilahlwe endaweni ezi different. We are still lucky those things have not happened. Or maybe should we say God is on our side. But maybe sometimes God will be focusing on Western Cape and then something happens at KZN and it happens here. So we need to realize ukuthi we are the first point of protecting this body. It's us. Young Tol. So there's a lot that needs to be done.
Okay.
What needs to be done as I said, the issue you create ama awarenesses. The issue maybe you create ama pamphlets.
Yes.
And The type of student that we have today depends mostly on a phone.
Yes.
it's no longer that student that would want to read a placard there. Even if a placard can be there, it's fine, but we need to also have things that we push, nabo CMD, that would actually go into kubama pop-ups.
Okay.
In the spaces that you are in, guma computers, no longer nago internet or intranet, there is something that comes up and say, there's this that needs to be done. Remember, there's this. You know, if you go to our airports, for those who have traveled, every 10, 15 minutes, there is an announcement that you cannot leave your bag unattended. If security spots gutina ipek ihleli lapha, it has not been attended for over 10 minutes, they come, they remove it. And you will have to go and explain uguti what is in the bag and so on.
Mm.
And that thing was actually created by the fact uguti countries like America, Britain and all that were riddled by terrorism. Terrorists will take ama TNT, the explosives, and put them in a bag. By Tatebawe Begalapa with a timer. Yeah, I'm sure you've seen those things in the movies.
Yes,
and
yes.
Then Bapume Baham.
Bapume Baham.
And Ikeli Pek, no one is attending to it. Sbaning Ilapia Siyazla. And the next thing, there's an explosion. We're all dead. So we need to think along those lines when it comes to crime. We need to come up with ama anti-crime strategies. Which is one of the things that we are busy working on. And one of the crimes, for instance, which calls other crimes, it's the issue of vandalism. Our university is severely vandalized. Every corner ohamba kuyo kuna something ebonisa, and ama student will justify it ngokuthi hey mina nje bengafuna ukusizwa amasikhala ngento enje. But this is your university. It's the university takes ukufanele tomorrow. Why do you vandalize it? You know, every protest that we have kufanele ukuthi ibe net destruction. And think about ama repairs and refurbishment of those. They take years. You know, someone was saying to me the other day, in fact, Uchuchu, when he was here, he looks at the student center, he says, what happened here? So I say, well, someone decided to go to Aishi Selenda. And he says, you know, this is something that needs to be dealt with. And decisively so. And I agree with him. I'm not into politics.
Okay.
That is why I'm here. I'm not into politics. I was in politics during my youth years and all that, but not anymore.
Okay.
So those are some of the things that need to be sort of pumped into our minds. But, hey, let's not destroy what we have. You know, it's like a community which says, and then they bend the clinic down because I'm not disparate. You know, and then tomorrow, babu, bazo toito ya good. Asina community clinic. Eba ishisilebo. So this is what we are doing. And that mentality needs to come to an end. And how does it come to an end? It's when we continuously drill these things into our mind. Good guys, this is ours. I mean, kona manje a library. If I may say this, a library, there's a corner in Nugumkamu, ngaphakathi library. And he's laughing, he knows about it. Nugumkamu, because someone akafuna ukuya toilet to decide ukuthi ayochamela ekhoneni because akuna camera embonayo. Are we going to put cameras everywhere?
Hey.
Guys, this is the best camera. This one. Let's use it effectively. Let's use it properly. As kombiseni ukuthi siyabantu abaku institution of higher learning.
Okay.
You understand?
Yes.
Let's think different. Early this year, makuzoyenza iregistration. These young
February.
Yeah. These young people abafikayo bazo register abaphethe ama IDs abo and ama copy wama matric results and all that. And those copies is ama CAO and all that. So they are here to register, you know, and obviously they don't know what is happening.
Okay.
But their thinking should be different from thinking yenu. But what these guys do, bahamba by six, babuye mtuba. And then, but hlangana nondo sundo suthi, hey, nifuna usizo, you know, we need help and all that. And then, undo si take these things, look at them and say, okay, all right. Into engayenza faka nama phone ngaphakathi ngoqoqe lezinto bafaka ama phone bamnika. Angene go one of the lecture halls.
Yes.
La kuma ALs.
Yes.
Aphumele kulomnyango ngale ngasemuva. Gone. Bahlale bona ke lapha.
Balendile ukuthi uyaphuma.
So around 5 siyabathola lapha. Guys, why are you here? Dai silinde omunye baba uthe uzosiza ngeregistration. Because they have not been customized to the environment. Bayasaba nokuthi bangene kuma lecture halls. They don't know what a lecture hall is and all that. So you see, the thinking is different from me thinking yomuntu osekudala ala university. Umuntu ekufanele ukuthi azi ukuthi I cannot decide good because no one sees me, I must pee in that corner. So our thinking, I do not want to use the expression as a black community, but our thinking as young people, as the future leaders, need to change.
Babu Sehlogo, siyakuzwa futhi siyabonga. Asibuke ama future goals e PSD. Mhlawumbe sesivala sesigoqa njengamanje. Ngifisa sikhulume ngawo.
I PSD is not a stagnant organization.
Okay.
Remember when PSD started, it started with less than 10 people.
Oh.
Number 60s. No,
61.
61, 62. Yeah. And okay. By then there was about less than 300 students. So, and those guys, Abante Beba Patama Nopkiri. You remember, well, you wouldn't know.
I know Donkey Piri. Donkey
yeah,
Piri.
Yeah, you call it Donkey Piri, oh, but I'm talking about a Nopkiri Sakila.
Oh.
So, PSD comes from that era.
Mm.
And then it moved into the format that it holds now. The format is in Ayomanje, it's similar to a police station. And I think that's what also creates a problem because some students, they think mabazegi tibazo reporter, then ba reporter ma poison. We are not police.
Okay.
We are simply a security establishment. Basically, we are a private security.
Okay.
Why private security? There's no difference between us and Excellent, Nabo Makeda, Nabo Rhino Security. There's no difference. We are a private security which is attached to an institution of higher learning.
So mangikubambule, so PSD initiates into efana nabo Excellent, MCAT.
We outsourced some of the activity to them.
Okay.
So everything that they do, in monitoring and evaluation yomsebenzi wabo, it's done by us. The guys in blue.
Okay.
It's PSD, okay. Which those are the insourced security services of the university.
Okay.
So, because of the numbers, earlier on I wanted to talk about the issue of ratios.
Okay.
Generally, in security states, for each and every 50 people, there should be 1.5 security.
Okay.
It's either you have 1 or 2 securities.
Okay.
So now, I said to you, on a daily basis, we've got about 130 securities. And you guys ni about 14,000 here, 14,000 to 15,000 on a daily basis. What is the ratio? You do your own maths.
Including the staff.
Including the staff.
Okay.
So you do your own ratio. So that is why ngithi we can put up all these things, sifaka ama camera, sifake ini nani. But the best person to protect you, it's yourself. If you keep yourself safe, then we have done half the job.
Okay.
You see. So what is it that we are going to do in the future? We are going technology. The world is going technology.
Yes.
The university, one of the strategic goals of the university is to make UniZulu a smart university.
Okay.
That is why, for instance, we're putting up our 10 styles which are going to have what is called facial recognition. So you might not even need to carry a student card.
Okay.
You know, your face will be a student card. Immediately, vela and just six scanner. No, we know this guy.
Okay.
And all that. So those things are very costly. I don't want to talk about the issues in Mali, nama NSFAS and all that, but they are very costly. But gradually, we need to move towards that direction.
Okay.
I visited a university in 2016. That university, it was in Asia.
Okay.
It has got about 6 officers and then 4 armed response. And the 4 armed response, bahlala somewhere else. And then the 6 bane office bahleli nje kuma kunama screens. And in these screens they are monitoring each and every corner. And then if kuna something but dispatchali a team of 4. You'll never see security around. The students in that country do not litter. The students know where the dustbin is. Lana nihlala la nidla ma chips. Man phakama nishiya khona lapho. By few abacabangayo ukuthi hey, that is why ngithi soft targeting. We need to target the soft matter. The mind. Deal with the mind. Change people's thinking, change people's way of doing things. So we need to go technology. We need to bring in artificial intelligence.
Okay.
Technology must be in the position to tell us, ukuthi, in that bag, there is something enje.
Okay.
Do you understand? And then, kufike enje tina, we are trying kona manje. Bako wanabanya enje, umuntu ubona sesifika sesizomlanda ukuthi mfethu. Sizokulanda.
Ngesibhamu lapha kathi.
Uyangithola. And ukuthi sazi kanjani. The story for another day. But those things are coming.
Siyabonga kakhulu mbukeli wayo iCampus Connect usahleli naye uGova Juice umaqabula sondela into ezimnandi intizozohlala ikuthathi kubeke ikhiphi kufaka hlale kumoja hlale kumnandi hlale kushap babusihloho sibonga kakhulu mhlawumbe amazwi ongavalelisa ngawo babukeli beCampus usuyivala usuyigoqa ungathini.
You know, the fear of crime, it's the beginning of wisdom. I think you need to start fearing ukuthi there is crime out there, and then you'll save your life. That's all what I think should be said.
Okay.
Thank you, Kwava Juice.
Babu Sitloho. Okay. So we valid. Okay, fine. Okay, so it did. Babu Sitloho, if it's a sikhulume nge-app, le oke wathe wayithinta ya emgadi si downloada kanjani isebenza kanjani usithi wanyawanya kabile kathathu.
Basically i app ye emgadi, I think if you go onto the internet and google i emgadi, it will take you to i site yabo, and then you should be in the position to google it. But there's also ama flyers akhona lapha PSD amanya khona library. Can go there, get a flyer, and just follow my instructions. How do you actually download that whole app?
Okay.
And then you are in.
Okay.
Yeah.
Siyabonga kakhulu. Khlele kumnandi, khlele kumoya. UGova Juice uzoluke kuthathi kufake keep it back. Siyabonga kakhulu. Xaxa. Babu Sitloho. Siyabonga kakhulu.
Bonga mina.
Siyabonga kakhulu. I production team yami sisebenzisa qhatha.